All right. I ran out of storage space last session. So I quit immediately after. You didn't miss anything. And right now it seems that we reverted back to borderless full screen. So I'm actually going to restart the game. And now we are in real full screen. Hey, a skill. We were here. I think we've been sent way off course. She was fishing in a threaded river east of Home Tree. She was headed towards Spinner Circle. And that's over here. And an island. Guessing it's here. Also be here. Okay, let's do that then. There's also the few islands we're gonna pass by on the way here. I bet you can attack those wasp nests and it'll release the bees on the humans. About a fallen log. in the river. She would head towards Spinner's Circle Domain. Islands of large fallen log and purple trees. Okay, so it's not here. Okay, I'm very sure where it is. I remember purple trees. Okay. Wow, I believe that's pristine. So many mistakes there.
The sap. If you enjoy cooking, you might enjoy this ingredient from beyond the Kinglor Forest.
Thank you for these gifts.
We've been in here. We've not been in here. Shit, I'm stuck. What? That's like a Dark Souls shortcut. It just goes back. I mean, okay. I guess it makes sense as like a... from like a realism point of view. Having like the hidden door. Makes it like a protected position, you know? You could sit with a bow on that upper room. Ready to snipe anybody coming in. All right, we gotta get up there. there either is an easy path here or... Well, every path's an easy path when you're just a god at climbing. Wait, is there a super easy path? Maybe. When you jump down on like a tree or something, or maybe just on any platform, but especially on a tree canopy, I've noticed the game will basically sort of auto-aim for you in terms of making sure you land roughly where you can land. As long as you don't like adjust the direction too much when you're falling. The game will let you land on like forest branches and stuff, which is a very nice touch, because otherwise how would you like ever succeed at landing on those thin branches, right? But I think they should have made out a skill that you train up in the game. They should have made it like a an in-game ability, like, yeah. Should be something you get as you progress the story.
Such gifts Ewa shares with us.
Like, I don't know, what was this game tag? This game's tagline was like, become Navi or whatever.
Greetings.
So as your main character becomes Navi, okay, you should like get those abilities over time. I think in the beginning you should have to. And manually.
Are you perhaps looking for blade-wing moth blades? One is nearby.
Okay. I don't know what that is, but it sounds epic. But actually, I think I already have one, right? I feel like I already have one. One of these, there's a fallen log. Yes, inside search area.
Fallen log? Should be where Nawuk saw that lone human. But what else? No, not yet. But what else? Doesn't look right. Don't think so. Someone from the resistance was here. Not RDA. Good. Maybe it's linked to whoever was here. They kicked the tree. Brought down the hive. Not smart. Someone ran. Fast. So fast they dropped their tablet. Let's see. A resistance human flew here to work on something and kicked the tree. Frustrated, maybe? Tablet could have more. Alex might know who owns this tablet.
All right. Alright, so it's either Gossamer Lakes, there's two quests there, and there's also the north of the home tree thing. The Gossamer Lakes are here, so we'll, Stoneblade Ridge. We'll do the Gossamer Lakes.
Thank you.
No need. It lets us appreciate Ewa's beauty.
Always nice to see a friendly face. Hello.
These trees are like tracing me around.
The forest used to be so beautiful before the sky people came.
What do you mean? It is still beautiful.
The sky people's devastation has blemished her beauty.
Yes, that is true. But her beauty will return in full again. Do not worry. The beast will not come closer.
Really? The research station way back. Thank you. Okay.
For these gifts.
I think I moved past it.
You are Sarentu. Hello. Do you wish to improve your equipment? Here, take this.
Is there like some way to like grab one of everything? Like why isn't that a button? Okay, we can make this thing. Thank you. take 30% less damage. Well, that's very strong. Oh yeah, we don't even have room in the pouch. Although, since I did all this, let's do a cooking session. Perfect. Isn't this thing rain optimal conditions? Yes. You know what? This optimal condition stuff, the fact that it's like time of day based or whatever, it's actually really clever, because what it does is that it just basically rewards the player for learning about all the botany facts, you know, like, you spend a lot of time reading botany lore in that 2009 game, and in this one, so it's really good that there's, like, some reward for it, at least a little bit. Hello? What? I don't know about this thing. It seems a little bit procedurally generated to me. Again. This is new. We stumbled on it!
You are the young Sarantu I heard so much about. Please, come. Hello, my friend. Would you care to join me for a meal and a story? I promise flavors that delight both the palate and the mind.
Sounds great. What are you cooking?
Oh, no, young one. You are in charge of the meal. For my part, I will provide the cooking lessons and the story. After all, it is the way of the Sarantu to learn the way of the other clans.
I'd be happy to, then. Where are the ingredients?
But the gathering is part of the journey, you see. You must collect some shell fruit as the main ingredient, then crimson mushrooms for flavor. We need pristine ones, too. Do not settle for inferior quality. Take your time when harvesting and be wary of damaging them.
Shell fruit and crimson mushrooms. Sounds simple enough.
Simple recipes are often the trickiest ones to master, young Sarantu. And this one is the simplest of all. Unfortunately, the Sky People's corrupting touch has befouled everything, including these fruits and mushrooms. Still, there are some exceptional specimens to be found if you look hard enough. Follow my instructions, and I promise you a story that will make it worth your while.
The ingredients I need. Any idea where I should look for them?
Shell fruit grows on large trees all across the land. Be sure to approach them with caution. As for the crimson mushrooms, you will find those on large roots in swamp areas.
Is there any particular place I can find both?
Walk towards the stone arches in the distance, then down into the swamps below. You will spot plenty of crimson mushrooms among the roots. From there, head back into the forest next to the waterfall, and you will soon come across some plump and juicy shell fruit.
Uh-oh, we got something covering up the screen here. Debating whether it's worth it to do anything about it. I'm gonna purge the chat, but it requires me to restart OBS. Maybe I can just reload this overlay. I was thinking of a solution to this bot stuff where, like, what was the solution? I mean, you could just, like, have, like, a count must be at least 2 years old setting or something. I don't quite know how to reload these things live. I just certainly don't want to fuck it up right now. For OBS.